Today I'm giving away this Orb Duality, as that's what you guys voted for on Discord. I do these giveaways every day, so if you want to get involved, make sure you're in the Discord. It's linked down below. And make sure you've liked the video, left a comment, and subscribed with notifications on. Here are the best OBS settings for streaming or recording gameplay on the newly released Counter-Strike 2, or honestly, any other game or whatever piece of content you want to record. So guys, as you can see, I've got OBS open right now. Real quick, if you've got any scenes like I have down here in the bottom left-hand corner, you're going to have to redo them. But firstly, let's go over to settings. In your general settings, there's really not much to change. I currently have this on Yami, but you could try whatever theme you like, but honestly, Yami is probably the best, and it is the default. Obviously, if you're streaming, you want to come down to this stream tab, and then swap this to whatever streaming platform you use, whether that's Twitch, YouTube, Facebook Live, maybe you stream on Restream, or Twitter, but you guys probably know how that works. And then also, if you're going to stream on something like Kick, you need to use Custom, and then put the server and stream key in, which you'll find on your dashboard. Now, for Twitch, it's a lot easier. You literally just have to click Login, and you just sign in with Twitch, and boom, it's connected. Now, another thing you can do is check ignore streaming service setting recommendations. And obviously, this can have an impact on your stream, but we'll be going through their settings. So as long as your internet's good enough, it shouldn't really matter. So just click yes and apply. Oh, another thing, obviously, here, if you come to where it says Twitch chat add-ons, definitely make sure to enable Better TTV and Franker Faces. This is just for emotes and stuff like that in your chat. And yeah, you really want these. It makes Twitch, it makes the chatting experience way better for anyone who's watching your stream. And then yeah, click apply. Then go down to output, and you want to swap it to the advanced mode. I can't change this at the moment because I'm recording, but if it's on simple, just switch it to advanced. So starting off in streaming settings, unless you have anything set up, just keep this default. I have things set up specifically for me, so that, for example, in my Twitch VOD track, it's recording everything in 2, which is pretty much everything minus any music. So if I was streaming songs which could get flagged for DMCA, like, then yeah, on the Twitch VOD, it's not going to show up. So yeah. Now, for your audio encoder, you want FFmpeg AAC, and for the video encoder, you want NVIDIA NVENC H.264, or whatever the alternative is for AMD. Ignore the rescale output. Now, guys, I just went through and checked these, but one thing that you do want to change is you want to change this from CBR, which is for constant bitrate, and you want to change this to CQP. And then for the best quality, what you want to do is swap this 20 to 16. The lower you go, better the quality is, but honestly, guys, don't go below 16, otherwise you will experience issues. And if on 16 you have some issues, you can put it back up to like 18, or even back to 20 if need be, but 16 for most people works well and makes the stream look super crispy. For keyframe interval, 2 seconds. For your preset, you want this on slowest for the best quality. Again, if you're having some kind of like issues in game or you're lagging a bit, then you can drop this down to P6 or P5. I wouldn't go below slow though, otherwise your quality is going to start, you know, looking a bit rubbish. Now for tuning, this again, it's kind of down to you, but what I would say is use ultra low latency, as it's just better for your gaming experience. But if you want your stream to look super nice, then obviously have this on high quality. But I mean, if you're playing Counter-Strike, it's a competitive game, you want to have as low a latency as possible. So yeah, I would use ultra low latency if I were you. Then for multipass mode, if you can use full resolution, you can drop this down to quarter resolution, and honestly, it makes barely any difference. So again, if you're slightly struggling for frames when streaming or recording, drop this down to quarter resolution, as yeah, it will just take a tiny bit of load off and really doesn't change much. But if you can, just use full resolution. It's the best that you're going to get. And for the profile, I recommend using high. And then for look ahead and psychovisual tuning, you can keep these both unchecked. Psychovisual tuning can actually be quite a good thing to use, but again, try this out. You can then also try it without it and just see whichever one works best for you guys. And then for GPU, put 0, and then your max B-frames 2. Now that is all your streaming settings done, so you can now click apply, and we'll hop over onto the recording tab. So guys, I'm back now, and I have swapped my canvas and my output to 1536 by 864. So you want to swap both of these to that. You actually have to type it in, and you have to type the X between the numbers. Again, there'll be no downscale filter. And again, just set your FPS to 60. Now, some of you might be thinking, why the hell are you telling me to set this to some random resolution that's lower than 1080p? And guys, that's mainly just because, as you guys can see on Twitch, most people who are going to be watching their stream will often have this list of streamers on the left-hand side on their screen and chat, which makes the actual video playback quite a lot smaller. I mean, even if they have this minimized, yes, it's a slight bit bigger, but most of the time they'll have chat up at least. So yeah, their preview is never actually going to be 1920 by 1080 pixels. 9 times out of 10, it'll be that 1536 by 864. So why pump out 1080p quality if the majority of people aren't even going to actually watch it in full screen? Now, of course, there are some people, so if you just want like the best of the best, you can stream in 1080p. It's up to you guys, but you've got to also think about bitrate and how streaming works. Obviously, if you're streaming at a lower resolution but using the same bitrate, basically Technically, your quality per pixels is going to be higher if you're streaming at a lower resolution, but at the same bitrate, if that makes sense, guys. And yeah, as I said, all the data shows that the majority of gamers and people who are on Twitch, they're watching on 1080p screens and they're watching in non-full screen. So honestly, this just makes the most amount of sense. That means that if you're streaming CSGO, which, you know, is a game that you're moving around a lot in, you want as high a bitrate as possible. And yeah, using that slightly lower resolution just means that the quality of that playback for your viewers is going to be as good as possible. It's basically just a better bang for your buck, if that makes sense. You've also got to think that a lot of people watch streams on their phone. So streaming in slightly lower resolution, it's pretty much going to be unnoticeable for 99% of people. And especially if you're a small streamer, you kind of want to be getting the best bang for your buck, because if a viewer clicks on your stream and you're streaming in like 4K, 15,000 bitrate, I mean, you're capped anyway on Twitch, which is why we're using the settings we're using. But yeah, if you're just starting off and someone clicks on your stream and it starts lagging, then they're most likely just going to click off and go and watch someone else. So yeah, I hope that makes sense. Now for hotkeys, you can sort this to whatever you guys want. Same with accessibility, I just leave this as default. Now for advanced, what you want to do is have this as normal. You can sort this to above normal or high if you want to, but I just leave it as normal. Make sure under the video tab that the renderer is DirectX 3D11, color format is NV12, color space is Rec 709. I'd also have this as limited, as full doesn't really make much of a difference and can look weird for some people. And then yeah, everything else pretty much just keep the same. I also make sure to automatically remux to MP4 because we're going to be recording in .mkv files. So just do this, it'll then remux stuff automatically for you so you don't have to do it. Then if you want stream delay, you can enable that here as well. Just leave automatically reconnect to what it is. And yeah, that's pretty much everything, guys. So yeah, now you can just click apply to save all these settings and then okay, and then you're ready to go. If this video helped, please do remember to leave a like on it. If you want to enter the giveaway, leave a comment. And if you want to watch some more CS2 content, click the video on your screen right now.